Hello everyone. If you check out Apache Zookeeper, you would realize it's an amazing tool. You can do a lot of distributed tasks using Zookeeper, be it a distributed lock or be it queue. A lot of things can be done using the Zookeeper. In fact, I have made a playlist on Apache Zookeeper and how to use Zookeeper and perform various tasks using Java client. Now the problem with that approach of using the Java client and implementing all the scenarios is that the code is very verbose. You have to take care of the race condition. You have to implement all the nuances which Zookeeper has, because in all the cases, Zookeeper server is running and all the logic of having the logs or having the distributed queue is at the client side. So it gets quite complex. And that's where we have something called as Apache Curator. Now this Apache Curator is nothing but a library for doing a lot of common tasks like a distributed queue or lock, and it has things like retrials. It makes the testing of Zookeeper easy, and it also has counters. So it has lots of common scenarios which are there with the Apache Zookeeper and which you would have to implement yourself. So let's quickly get started and see what exactly is Apache Curator. So this Apache Curator, you can go to curator.apache.org and you can see the documentation, its introduction, its pitch. And initially, it was originally developed by Netflix and later it became Apache project. Now, this Apache Curator, it has a bunch of components and that's how they have divided their own system. But the Uber idea is that you can do a lot of ready-made steps by just importing the Apache Zookeeper into a project. So the first thing is that you can have a better Zookeeper client with Apache Curator. So you already have a Apache Zookeeper client with a native Java library. But here you get things like retrials and the connection management. And you also get a test server. So you don't have to actually launch a Zookeeper server to do your coding. The second is that the curator framework gives you something called as namespaces. And we'll look into it using a code that how easy it is using the curator framework. And it makes the flow of the Zookeeper easier. Now, the third one is very interesting. It implements lots of ready-made recipes like leader election, lock, barrier, counter, cache, queues. So all these things are put in a form of library. And when I talk about the queue, it is not just one type of queue. There are different type of locking mechanism, shared queue and stuff, which they implement and then they share. So you just have to use those libraries and you don't have to care about the nuances. So it's tested library. You just import, for example, you import a queue, and then you can just enqueue and dequeue the data from the queue. You don't have to have a bunch of code written for that. And yes, if especially in the distributed world, if you already have a tested code, then why not? The fourth one is the utilities component, where they have a test server and the test cluster. So whenever you want to test something and you want to put a functional test or let's say a unit test, for those cases, you don't have to actually launch a Zookeeper server. So in that way, if you just have a test server with you, and you can just instantiate a test server by something called as testserver.start, and it will just start for you and it will do the job. And the last is the extension or extra recipes. So there is already something called as recipe, which has lots of things. But this extension, what it does is that it gives you extra recipes. So that not everything is packaged in one recipe, but whatever things which would be needed in some of the scenarios, they are extra. And you can again import those extensions and use it. So now let's quickly see the code part. This is the Maven-based project for Apache Zookeeper Curator client. So what I have done here is that I have imported a bunch of dependencies. And I'll share this code in the GitHub repo for you to refer as well. So the first thing I have imported is the curator client. The second is the curator framework. The third is the curator recipe. And the fourth is a curator test. So these four things I have imported. And if you remember, These are the things which were there when I was explaining the components. I have not included the extension part because you can go ahead and check out. I have just covered four of these in this particular videos. Now, if we talk about the simple curator client, what simple curator client does is that it connects to the Zookeeper server using the simple client, and it provides some extra functionality. For example, here the functionality provided is the retry functionality, and there are multiple types of retries available. For example, bounded exponential backoff, retry n time, retry one time, and retry until time elapsed. So this is how it runs. You can create a client object and then you can get a Zookeeper client, and then it runs the same way. So if I run this particular code from here, and I have already launched the Zookeeper server on my local so that we can see what node got created. So I have created a test node. Now if I go to the terminal and do ls, you can see a test node getting created. So this is how this one works. Now if I talk about the curator framework client, so it provides some extra functionality here. So it provides the functionality of namespace. So here I'm using a namespace called as myapp. So whatever path which I create under this client, it will be prepended with something called as namespace. So this will help you if there are multiple code bases and multiple services running in your company and you still have one Zookeeper server. All you need to do to have a different namespaces, and in this way when you run it, let me run it from here, you can see a test path got created, and let me make it persistent so that it doesn't get deleted when we check. So let me rename it to test path 1. So you can see a test path got created. Now if I move to the terminal and do ls, you can see a myapp created in Zookeeper. Now if I do ls myapp, you can see a test path and test path 1 got created. So the idea is that you have been able to prepend myapp to all the paths, whereas the subsequent code path was unaware of that namespace overall. So it's a very good way to isolate stubs. This particular facility was not available in the native Zookeeper client in Java. The third and the most interesting thing is the Zookeeper recipe. So this one gives you a ready-made code for a lot of things. So what I have done here is that I have implemented two stuffs. One is the counter and the other is a queue. To implement a counter, there is a library function called a shared count. So you can create a shared count and then you can start the shared count and you can increment the counter, and you can run multiple servers and they all can increment the counters overall. If you want to avoid the race condition, then you can use something called as lock. So even this is available as a part of Zookeeper recipe. So this is how you can create a lock, and then finally you can release the lock. So you can increment the counter. You can start with counter 1 and then you can reach counter 2, counter 3, counter 4, etc. I'll run it in a while. And this is the queue. So for queue also, you don't have to worry much about the distributed queue. You create a simple distributed queue and you can enqueue using the offer method, and you can dequeue using the take method. So this is how you can enqueue and dequeue the stuffs, and this is how you can have a counter in Zookeeper. The way you run it is, I'll just run it from here to show you. You can see going to implement an item and then it was able to dequeue it. Likewise, you could increment the counters as well. So this particular recipe is also available ready-made for you. So if there are multiple servers and you want to have such logic, you can just rely on Zookeeper and get your things done. You don't have to worry much about anything else whatsoever. And the last but not the least is the curator utility. So here I'll talk about the test server. So here you can see I'm running a testing server. I'm not running the actual server. So what I'll do is I'll shut down my current Zookeeper server running. So the way I shut down is zkserver.sh stop. So my Zookeeper server has stopped. Now if I run my code, the test code, it will still run fine because it will rely on the test server. So I'm creating a testing server and I can run all my code using this testing server. It will be very helpful for me in the CI/CD pipeline. It will be helpful for me while development. So overall, that's the idea, that with the help of Zookeeper recipes and the Zookeeper curator client, you can do a lot of stuffs. Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope this video was helpful for you to understand the use case of Apache Curator and how you can use it to make your life easy whenever you code for Apache Zookeeper. So that's all from my side for this video. Till the next time, bye.